One comment I frequently see on my videos is what tool is that you're using to monitor your system? So in this video, I'm going to go over a lot of different Linux monitoring tools I like to use, what I like to use them to monitor, and just generally what you can use to monitor different parts of your system. Hopefully this video teaches you a little bit more about these tools, and if you think I missed something, leave it in the comments below because there's probably a lot more tools than I covered in this video here. I'm also going to include how to install these tools on a couple of different distros when I mention the tools, so hopefully that works for you, as most of these tools are easy to install on most large Linux distributions. Also, I want to mention some of these tools are a little bit odd if you don't run them with sudo with some data missing, so if something seems off with one of these tools, try running them as sudo or root to just make sure it's not missing that data. Also, before I get into monitoring tools, I just want to mention Tmux for a second. This is a tool I really like using when I'm using lots of different tasks in a Linux system. And the big advantages I see is if I just run Tmux right now, I can split my screen in half using commands like Control B and percent sign, or Control B and this key here on screen to split it horizontally. The other cool thing is I can run a task like this, disconnect and exit the SSH session, and then I can reconnect to my SSH session on the computer, run tmux attach-d to disconnect it from other sessions it might be connected to, and then my tools are running again. This can be great for something like a file copy over SSH, where I can essentially disconnect or leave my SSH session, and then reconnect to it and see all my tools like they were laid out previously. There are other ways to do this, just one tool I found to be particularly useful for my use cases. Let's start off with tools that are able to monitor many different aspects of a Linux system, starting off initially with htop. This is an improved version of top, and lots of tools like using some letter and top naming. And it's just a nice little tool. You can visually see CPU, memory, and swap usage at the top, as well as some system information, and then see all the different tasks that are using and sort by the amount of usage each task has. And if you're running a relatively new distro and running it as sudo, it can also show disk I/O, so you can see what programs are maxing out the disk I/O on your system in case your disks are pinned and you're questioning what process is being used. Another tool I like using for just general system usage is btop. Very similar to htop in giving you a nice little graph right here for system utilization. This system isn't very heavily used, so it's all pretty low. But one of the cool features it has to me is it can show system clock speed and average on all the cores, as well as temperatures on all the cores with their graphs. In addition to what something like htop shows, it also shows network usage, and you can switch between controls, and is designed for larger screens with the ability to show lots of different information on the screen at any given time. Atop is another great tool for monitoring a lot of different aspects of a system. It's not the most pleasant looking information-wise, but it does pack a lot of things on there with the ability to color code some things in red if something's odd. There's a lot of data being crammed up here, as well as seeing your different processes that are running at different times. The other cool thing Atop is capable of doing is logging all this information to disk in case you want to replay that data or analyze it later on a different system. So take a look at its man page to figure out where those logs are going in case you want to log things like system usage, RAM usage, disk I/O, and a lot more later on. One other tool I like using for just basic system monitoring is dstat. Dstat by default will show system usage, disk I/O, net usage, page file use I/O, page file I/O, as well as system interrupts, with the capability of using many different parameters to show things like memory usage, temperatures, GPU usage, and a lot more if you read their man page. All of these tools have a man page with lots and many more different options to see way more information, so take a look at that man page if you like this tool and just want to see something more. But going back to dstat, one thing I really like is it's easy to see, is this I/O peaking or something? Because I can kind of see all these I/O parameters for the last second. So for example, looking at this system here, I can see in green when it goes to megabytes that I'm doing a few writes every once in a while, but it goes down to zero. I like seeing data over time because one measurement doesn't tell you something as it can often change quickly. And dstat, I think, does very well to me in that respect. Inmon is another tool that's capable of measuring many different aspects of a system. And by default, it doesn't show anything. So you want to use tools like C to show a CPU graph, or maybe M for memory, and it's capable of showing multiple of these at the same time. So you can load it up with many different graphs for different charts of data you want to see, see, for example, which disks are seeing I/O. So in this case, it looks like my NVMe drives are being occasionally written to. And I can see all my CPU usage with little graphs to see if it's user or system I/O that it's being presented on. One more interesting tool to monitor lots of different aspects of a system is glances. Glances is a nice tool that shows little graphical ways of highlighting things that might be important to keep your eye on. So for example, my memory usage is high and shown in red, and it also shows that high is 90% usage here, keeps an eye on things like swap and load averages, and has like a nice, relatively clean interface for just monitoring what tasks are using on a system and highlighting them if they seem abnormally high. Just another tool that can monitor many different aspects of a system in a little bit different way. And while all of these tools effectively show the same basic data with perhaps a little bit more interesting, I find some tools make a little bit more intuitive sense to my brain and likely different ones make more sense to yours. So just play with all of these and see what tells you more about your system. Now let's get into tools that are more specifically targeted towards parts of a system. Starting off with CPU monitoring is just the most basic top. This should come pre-installed on almost any Unix-derived system, and while it's missing a lot of the features of these other tools, the fact that it's pre-installed on almost anything is really nice, and just a nice way to see what processes are using what I/O. It has gotten better in some newer distros, but nice a basic CPU monitor. The next tool I want to look at for monitoring CPU usage is S-TUI. This tool, or stress-text user interface, is really nice for monitoring your system's temperatures, power consumption, and load over time, and really good for stress testing. And it actually works with stress, so if I switch its mode to stress right now, it's going to start maxing out my CPU, and I can see that utilization and frequencies have also changed on my system. I can see lots of information on the side here that can show me things like clock speeds, package power consumption, and a lot more, and can be a nice, easy way to see temperatures, clock speeds, and more on my processor, and a good single tool to do stress testing and monitoring of my CPU. Moving on to graphics cards, one of my favorite tools for just general graphics card monitoring is NVTOP. Styled after HTOP, this tool can show graphical usage for your graphics card, as well as some additional information like what processes are running, how much resources they're using on your system, like VRAM usage and GPU usage, and also show which ones are using the encoding cores. It used to be just for NVIDIA cards, but now supports almost any Linux GPU on your system, so you can easily see things like what's using it. My headless Linux system I'm using for demoing doesn't really show much interesting information, but I can see it has Intel UHD graphics that's doing nothing as I'd expect. Moving on to more specific tools for different brands of graphics cards, NVIDIA-SMI is installed if you have an NVIDIA graphics card and are using their proprietary driver, and shows things like power consumption, utilization, temperatures, and what processes are running on your card. Also, an FYI, this tool should also be available for Windows if you like using that tool there. For Intel cards, Intel GPU Top, part of the Intel GPU Tools package on most distros, is capable of showing the usage on your system. On my system, I can see right now it's doing basically nothing sitting idle as a headless system, but it is able to show what processors are running, the total usage of the card and usage of different things like video versus encoding, as well as other aspects, and what processors are using your GPU. For AMD cards, look at Radeon Top. It can show the usage of your system if you're using the open source Radeon driver, and just show general stats about those open source AMD cards. When it comes to monitoring memory usage on your system, the basic free task that's included with basically every Linux system is really nice. I like using it with the -h parameter so I can understand gigabytes and megabytes a lot more than straight bytes values in large numbers. This shows me how my memory and swap is being used on my system right now. Now it only shows it to me once when I run the command, but one nice tool that's relatively easy to install on a lot of distros is watch. Would effectively run the command over and over again and update the value on screen. This is really nice if you have a monitoring utility that just outputs it once and then you want to actually see it updated and kind of glance at it easily to see how usage has changed. One other way to monitor memory usage on your system is catting one of the /proc/meminfo files on your system. /proc has a lot of interesting files that show information about your system at that current time. So if I cat that file now, I see a lot more information about what's going on with the memory in my system in much more detail than what like free is using. And also one thing with a lot of these tools are, they're effectively just pulling data from /proc. So if you want to see the raw data yourself or make one of these tools, take a look under /proc because that's where most of this data is coming from. An additional memory monitoring tool that can be ran frequently is VMstat. I can run VMstat with one or another number to automatically update every that many seconds, and running it right now, other than its not super clean interface, will show me things like swap in and swap out, which I find is one of the best indicators of is swap actually a limitation on my system. And I can kind of monitor this and do other tests to see if swap shoots up. That likely is something worth taking a note of. When it comes to disk I/O, my favorite tool by far is using IOSTAT. I like using the -xm parameter. X shows more data, so for example, here is it without -x, but with -x, I get a lot more data. And some of this data that I find really useful is the percent utilization. If this number is high, your disk is being pushed and it's likely being the limitation for your task. The other thing that the X parameter shows me is stuff like queue depth, which can be important for seeing how drives will perform and a little bit more info. Mostly because I'm nerdy and want to play with all that internal data, but the simple might be enough. The next parameter I like using is M. M shows it in megabytes instead of kilobytes, which I find a lot easier to understand with modern fast drives. Adding a 1 at the end will automatically refresh it and show more data, so I can see it as it changes. Looks like this system's doing almost nothing disk IO-wise, but I like taking a look. One other thing that you might stand out to you is it has reads, writes, and the D is for discard. For stuff like SSDs, the trim operation's doing discards, so I can actually see right now it was doing some discard operation, likely as I was trimming unused space on the drive. Also, if you want to see only a specific disk, you can use -d and something like SDA, and then it'll only monitor that single SDA disk instead of all disks on your system. Moving on to network monitoring tools, there's lots of different tools depending on how you want to see networking on your system and what data you want to get. Starting off with a nice graphical utility to see the network utilization on your system is nload. One thing you might notice is I'm on Proxmox right now, and I have a lot of virtual network cards, which is why I have 51 network interfaces. So it can be a bit annoying at times to find what exact interface I want to be using, but it'll show the total amount of network I/O I have on any of these network interfaces. And if I can find one of these that actually has I/O going on it, it should show a graphical parameter of what I/O is going through the system. So I can easily glance over and see when more I/O is going through one of my network cards and when it isn't. The next tool I want to take a look at is iptraf-ng. What I like about this tool is it's able to show information about the TCP connections and which ones have the most I/O. So if I go under IP traffic monitor for all interfaces, I can see the amount of bytes that's being sent and what network cards and IP addresses it's being sent and received from on which interface. This can be a great way to figure out my system sending a lot of network I/O. Where is it going? I will note this is only TCP, UDP's on the bottom because it's different in how it does its connections. But if I am doing TCP, I can see port 22 is probably SSH and it's a local network IP address it's sending data to. That's probably this connection right now it's doing and can be a great way to troubleshoot what's using your network I/O. There's also a lot more information on the system, like trying to find out what packet sizes are being used on different interfaces. Could be used to see things like, is your large packets actually working correctly? And much more interfaces. iptraf-ng has come in handy if I want to get more detailed information about networking many times in the past for me. The next category of tools I want to take a look at involve monitoring what your system's doing in terms of temperatures, fan speeds, and a little bit more of those physical parameters on your system. And the best I've found to do that is sensors. And running sensors on my system shows me a lot of different information about this, though some of them do have issues, which you can configure by using the sensors-detect command to search your system for sensors and configure which ones you want to monitor and which ones you don't. Running it on this system right now, I can see it's monitoring my CPU core temperatures, my little NVMe drives, as well as a little network card it also is pulling temps from. And that's nice to just see a general, what are the temps of my system right now? If you have a system with IPMI, IPMI tool can also be a really nice way of monitoring what the IPMI is doing, as well as a lot more information about the IPMI on your system, though that needs compatible hardware, which this current test system I have does not have. Even with all of these tools, I still haven't found one that shows it in exactly the format I like to see. So I often combine multiple of these tools with Tmux to see a simple glance interface to monitor many different aspects of a system easily. One example view I have right now is with HTOP in the top left to see things like memory usage, top processes, and CPU usage. DSTAT in the top right so I can kind of see usage over time and if something's kind of a small peak or if it's an ongoing task. And IOSTAT at the bottom because I like to see kind of the disk IO and what disks are being stressed. I found this view to be quite useful and kind of have it loaded in Tmux on a lot of my different servers to just keep an eye on stuff. But let me know what works for you, if you learned anything useful in this video, or if I missed one of your favorite system monitoring tools in Linux. Thanks for watching this video and hope you found this informative or useful.